Hello, everybody. We are actually today going to solve or specify the Gurobi optimization model using C# on Visual Studio. So this is what is the documentation which gives you the reference, and we'll use the same example. So let's start. We start with our Visual Studio first. So Visual Studio, we'll create a new project. A console project, and then we name it Gurobi C# optimization model on .NET. All right. So this is what I'm storing it in one of the drive available, and then we use this same long-term support. We create a project. Now this is basic. It will be the things, basic things will come, but we don't need all these things. What I want to show is using Gurobi is giving us error. So first we have to include the library and then we'll code. So let's start how to add the library. So I have already installed the Gurobi optimization tool. So I just have to include. So go to the base library. For that, we have to add the reference. So project reference, we can say. And then go to the browse. Now we are supposed here, it is already there because I have used it once, but you can go if it does not exist, you can go to the browse, go where your actual base library is, go to the Win64 library, and you'll see the DLL file. Add that. And then you can see that in the assembly, this has been listed. Now that error has also gone. So this is just the brief how to include the DLL to the library. I have already the code. You can take it from the same website, right? So if we talk about, it is here, the same example we are taking, and you can find it here, right? So therefore you don't need this code, and therefore I'll not be providing it, but you know how to access it, right? So this is the documentation, quickstart.net, in that the first example. So we're taking the same example, and let me quickly explain it. This is a Gurobi C# model, and now you see there are no errors. The only reason is we have the supporting DLL associated with it. Then we bind in the main function, the try catch block, to catch the errors. First, we create the empty environment, and then set the options and we start. We create the empty environment. Why? Because before we create a model, we need an environment. So select the log file to use and then start. Later on, we will use this environment. So what we are doing is we are creating a log file, and this, I'll show you where the location of this file is, or after running, when it gets created, where the logs are stored, so that you can later on modify it and define the parameters and print it on that log file. And then you can directly generate the graphs using GNUplot. Here we are creating an empty model using this environment. So we can see that the constructor takes previously created environment as an argument. We create the variables using add variable method. We can also use multiple a variable creation using add variables method, but it's like purely depends on the model. We are, as of now, just discussing the arguments. First one is the lower bound, second one is the upper bound, third one is the linear objective coefficient, and thereafter, the type is the binary, and thereafter, we are defining the name of it. This is the name of the variable. So we have defined three variables, X, Y, and Z. Now this is coming from here. All right. So we are just defining the binary variable x, y, z. Now we set the objective function. So our objective function is maximize x plus y plus 2z. So that is what is our. So we have set first of all the equation, and then we are very clearly defining whether it is maximization problem or minimization. So that is the second argument. To add the constraints, you can add multiple constraints using add constraints or one by one constraint using add constraint. So model dot add constraint and then the equation. So we have it here, first, second, right? So this is the first one and this is the second. So the second argument is nothing but the name of the constraint. So first constraint, we gave it the name C0 and thereafter C1. We can also use the following code for building linear expressions. For example, GRB linear expression, define the object name, define it 0.0, and thereafter add these to x, y, and z using this code, and thereafter control it or add it to the constraint. The optimization model populates the attributes, build final solution using the simple code of model optimize. Thereafter, what we can do is we can access a lot of variable name and object variables. So here we are just taking care of only putting these values. But if you go to this link, you'll find a set of attributes you can access for optimization model. So let's take a quick look at it. If you observe here, this is what is the set of attributes. So we have some model attributes, and thereafter we have some variable attributes, and thereafter some linear constraint attributes, which we can define and it's up to us. And then some other additional quadratic equations or some solution related, the bound variables, also the number of nodes, all these significant network related attributes are accessible. So just use what you need. And as of now, we are just printing all the three variables and our objective function value. Once we have obtained and the objective function has successfully run, thereafter we need to set the resources free. So how we do it? First, we actually release the resources occupied by the model and thereafter the environment. Why? Because environment is holding the model. So if we dispose of the environment, the models will be still scattered, and then the garbage collection we have to wait for. This is helpful when the model becomes really, really heavy and resource management will not create an issues or crashing of systems and all issues can be resolved. We just want, in case if we are finding it, there are some mistakes, obviously there is a chance of a mistake. So to access exactly the errors related to Gurobi, we must access the Gurobi error statements using try and catch. So that's why we will be using GRB exception for accessing the exact errors. Let's run it and let's have a look. So now if we run it, we get this output. We have got the values of x, y, and z, and the objective function value as well. So this is what is the maximized value, because we did the maximization, and we can have a solution count 2, that is 3 and 2. So this is just a brief about it. Now, where can we find this entire log file? Because maybe we want to print it, right? Or we want to modify the output. So for that, we have to go to the project. So let's go to the project. The project name is Gurobi C# Optimization Model. .net. So we'll go to the location where it is stored. So if we go here, and then this is our project. So we go to the bin, we go to the debug folder, we go to the .NET core, and here you see MIP1 log file, which we created here, exactly. If you open it, the output is written. Now, this is up to you how you want to pull it, how you want to present it, and then how you want to present, means carry forward it to the other tools where we can create a graph out of it. That's it. So this is the easy and the first a kickstart to C# Gurobi projects. Thank you.